chair for that midnight woman, my darkest dream. She looks straight through me.
What are you reckoning?
I fancy us tonight, I really do.
Yeah? Get a result?
Yeah. Keep it tight at the back in the first half, push through in the second half, beat the offside trap boff result.
You reckon?
Yeah, I reckon. Can't be the same every bleeding week, can it?
I'll blame that one there, fought in brass.
Yeah?
He comes on 5 minutes before the end, just cleans up.
But he'd never last the full five acts, would he? Hasn't got the fatal flaw.
I don't know, he looks handy.
Come on, Hamlet, make your fucking mind up! Jesus!
Stop soliloquising, you Danish puff!
He's just not taking them on, is he?
I don't understand it. He runs rings round Polonius in Act 2, Scene 2, and he comes on like...
Here we go, look.
Three! Ooh, ah, Ophelia! I said, ooh, ah, Ophelia!
Get thee to a nunnery, get thee to a nunnery.
He's losing it.
Nah, he is but mad north-northwest. When the wind is southerly, he knows a hawk from a handsaw.
Claudius is staying down, look. Get up!
Get up off your knees, you fat bastard!
Get up, you bleeding fat bastard!
Who ate all the pies? Who ate all the pies?
He's fat! He's bad!
He murdered Hamlet's dad, Claudius! Claudius!
Stealing him, Hamlet!
Go on, stick him!
Go on, my son!
Percentages!
Fatal indecision.
Fatal!
He wants to do it when he is drunk asleep or in his rage.
Or in incestuous pleasure of his bed. Game, a swearing or about some act that hath no relish in it.
Yeah. Cunt.
Aye, aye, they're taking Polonius off.
Oh.
Play some.
Play. Who's coming on?
Young Laertes. Come on, lad, get a grip of it.
Ooh, gravediggers are warming up.
Oh, shit. I can't believe it's going to be the same result.
Christ!
What?
Alas!
What?
It is the poison cup.
It is too late.
Talk about own goal.
Every bleeding time.
Oh, the rest is silence.
Ah, well. Who have we got next week?
The Three Sisters.
You'll never get to Moscow. You'll never get to Moscow.
Are we playing for money?
That's the only way to play, Doc.
Would you like to do the honours, young man?
I will, sir.
Right. What's it to be, then?
Knockout whist.
Knockout whist? I think not, Doc. Let's have a round of slippery jack.
Excellent, sir, excellent.
I'm afraid I don't know how to play that one.
You don't know slippery jack, Doc? Doc doesn't know slippery jack, mate.
You don't know slippery jack, Doc. All right, let's have a round of 40-card drag.
Good idea, young man.
One, two, three.
40-card drag, is that the one that's a bit like poker?
Oh, don't you know any card games, Doc?
Yes, whist, knockout whist, rummy, pontoon.
No, come on, let's have a game of go, Johnny, go, 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 go!
Excellent, sir, excellent.
I'll just sort through these.
Look, I don't know how to play that one either.
Oh, everyone knows go, Johnny, go, 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 go!
I don't.
You do.
I don't.
You do. It's like a cross between Hoover and Eight Men Down.
I don't know how to play those either.
Oh!
That's okay. We'll just have to explain the rules to you then, Doc.
It's very simple.
Jacks are worth 10, kings are worth 3.
Apart from one-eyed jacks, which are wild cards.
Yeah, but we'll come to those in a minute.
Round 1, you get a hand of 9, round 2, a hand of 7.
2's a wild card.
But we'll come to those in a minute.
Apart from diamonds, which retain their face value.
Except the king of diamonds, obviously.
Obviously. We play in sequence unless you can match a pair or play a card in ascending or descending order.
If you can, that's a go, Johnny, go, 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 go.
You stand up, pick up all the cards at the table and shout, go, Johnny, go, 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 go.
Winner is the man with the most tricks after 15 hands.
You'll pick up the rest as we play. Shall I say a pound around?
Just one thing. Are queens worth 12?
What queens?
Queens in the pack.
The pack? Sorry, what's the pack?
It means the deck.
Doc, there are no queens.
We're playing with a French pack.
Deck, my...
A French deck, stand correct, it's up.
Thank you, young man.
Oh.
Right, who's to lead?
I think that's you, Doc.
Oh, I'm not really sure how to start.
Well, just put a card on the table.
Come on! A 5.
You can't lead with a 5!
This is go, Johnny, go, 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 not bam, bam, a fist, fat!
Sorry.
Start again. Very interesting, Mr. Bond. Sit.
Ace in the hole. Town. What?
Oh, come on, Doc.
What?
Well, that's a go, Johnny, go, 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 go.
Is it?
Well, you can't touch them.
Why not?
You've got to say, go, Johnny, go, 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 go.
Go, Johnny, go, 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 go.
I have to stand up first.
And say, go, Johnny, go, 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 go.
Go, Johnny, go, 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 go.
Right, now name your pairs.
What?
Name your pairs.
You didn't sing about naming pairs.
You put down a 5.
Yes.
Well, if you put down a 5, you must have pairs.
Why must I have pairs?
Because that's a go, Johnny, go, 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 go.
Oh, for God's...
Well, you can't look at
them. Well, I'm supposed to remember them.
That's the whole point.
Look, jacks are worth 10, kings are worth 3.
Apart from one, I just
would. Ah! Why can't we just play something simple? And why do we only ever play things that you two know the rules of? It was like this when we were kids. You used to put bets on bloody hungry hippos. Why can't we just play hangman or something?
All right, Doc.
Whatever you say, Doc.
Hangman it is.
Hangman sounds good to me.
I'm sorry.
It's all right, hangman. You're playing Canadian rules or Italian?
All right, do we have a Pam Doof, please, or a Pamela Doof?
I'm Pam Doof.
Hello.
A bit nervous.
Is it Pam or Pamela?
Pamela, whatever.
Right. Do you mind if you stick to Pam? It's just I know a Pamela.
Fine.
My name's Jed Bishop. I'm... I'm directing the play. What are you going to do for us today?
I've got a Shakespeare or a modern.
What's your modern?
It's Top Girls.
Churchill. Mm. What's your Shakespeare?
It's Isabella's pleading scene from Measure to Measures.
Ooh, I'd like to see that, please.
Okay.
It's an interesting one, isn't it, Measure? I directed a production a couple of seasons back.
And... Oh, no!
It's okay. We had a guy playing Isabella, sort of kabuki thing. So tell me, what drew you to this piece in particular?
The language. Mm. Really good images within the text, and I liked the meter.
Go on.
Oh, and I think there's emotions in it.
She's very repressed, isn't she, Isabella?
Yes, but I like that about her, the fact she's feeling all these different things, and yet she is a really calm person, and she manages to kind of keep it all in.
Good. Good. Well, in your own time.
should I have played you, believe me? Oh, perish my never in terms of dead dog with a condemnation. All right, to thank Dr. Petiti, to follow us in class, and to my brother!
Powerful stuff.
Yes.
Tell me, Pam, have you trained?
No.
Friday 16th, or Saturday 17th of March, 1912. Oates would not give up hope to the very end. He was a brave soul. He said, "I'm just going outside, and maybe some time."
He walked out into the blizzard, and we have not seen him since.
Sir.
Yes, Birdie.
Well, I know we're done for and everything.
Yes.
I was just wondering. Mrs. Scott. Your wife.
Kathleen?
Yes. Do you have any regrets?
I suppose I'd like to have been a better husband to her and a father to little Peter. I regret I shall never again see her lovely face, nor hear the sweet music of her laughter.
Not anything else?
What do you mean?
Doesn't matter.
I'm afraid Uncle Bill's had it, Birdie.
Really think so, sir?
He hasn't moved for more than an hour. Good old Bill. I wish now I'd never asked him to come. He was the best.
You mustn't blame yourself, sir. It's rotten luck, that's all. Sir. Mrs. Scott again.
Yes.
What are her tits like?
I beg your pardon?
Nothing, sir.
I heard you quite distinctly.
No, it was a rum thing to say. Ignore me, sir.
I should have listened to Nansen. He told me to take more dogs. I said to him, "I'm going south. Any advice?" He said, "Con, dogs, dogs, and dogs again."
Sir, has she ever brought you off with her hand?
Babe! I've been patient and tolerant. This really is beyond the pale.
Oh, the thing is, sir, I've never known a woman in the fullest sense. I've never had a tender female hand on my... well, any hand, for that matter.
What are you trying to say?
Well, we're going to die, sir. The three of us, three men in a tent.
Yes?
I just thought, why don't we go out with smiles on our faces?
Burns! This is unbelievable. I think I've had such faith in you. You've been such a brick, such a tower of strength throughout the entire expedition. And now at the hour of our ultimate trial, you give in to these base, unchristian desires.
I don't mind being the woman if that's what...
That's not what I'm asking, mate!
My wife's got a fanny like a bear trapper's hat.
Bill?
Go on, Con, the lad's got a point. You do him, I'll do you.
Oh,
well, where's the harm? No one need know. Or do you have to write everything down in that fucking diary of yours?
I do keep a diary, a secret diary. Would you like to hear some? Oh. March the 4th, awoke today with a morning glory like a tent peg.
I remember that day, I was just the same. I could hardly get my trousers on. I had to bang it on the bell end with a drop.
God! Pull yourselves together! Bill, Birdie, for the sake of what we fellows have been through together, let's at least die like English gentlemen. Please. All right, Birdie, we'll do you first, but I get to go before her.
Is this yours or mine?
It's ours.
Oh, come on, Russell, don't talk like that.
Like what?
Is it yours or mine?
You paid for it.
Meaning?
It was a present, Robert.
Well, you keep it then.
I don't want it. Give it to your boyfriend.
I haven't got a boyfriend.
You did have.
Well, don't answer it.
I have to. I'm expecting someone.
Who?
Tish.
Oh, shit. Not her.
Hello, stranger. God, you look awful. Hi, Robert Bates. Come visit Snuggington. Listen, could I be a complete pain and bum a ciggy off you? Mm-hmm. I've just been sitting on a bus for like half an hour and I'm like, give me nicotine, give me caffeine, now please. Oh, cheers, babes, you're a star.
Actually, Tish, it's not a very good time.
I'll bum you back a roly when I've got some skins. Anyway, I've just been down to Camden Market to buy this floppy felt hat and some crystals and shit. It's fab, isn't it? I'm going to wear it to Mardi Gras next year. You guys are going to love it. Close 28, yay! Anyway, I'm sitting on the bus and I start getting these really weird vibes because I'm due to start blobbing next week anyway. God, I love gay guys. You can actually talk about periods and not feel guilty, yes.
Russell.
So I'm sitting there, and there's a guy next to me, and he is like major cuteness. He was to die for. You guys would have loved him. Especially you, Robert. You're such a slut. Oh, text message from Scott and Ian at Chilente.
Look, I think I better be going.
No.
Oh, you off, babes. Okay, darling, don't be a stranger. Oh, and Robert, could Tish bum another shiggy off, oh, please? God, I am such a fag hag.
Here, you can have the whole packet I've given up anyway.
Oh, major generosity. Cheers, darling, you really is a star. Come give Tish a big kiss and a snuggle. Now give Russell a big kiss and a snuggle. Aw, they're so cute. I love gay guys, I really do. Anyway, Russ, I've decided to hand in my notice at work. The women are all bitches and the guys are bastards, apart from the gay guys, obviously. Oh, what are you doing?
He's left me. Robert's left me, he's not coming back.
Was he sleeping with someone else?
I don't think so.
Oh, you poor thing. I'll just get this. Hi, Scott, babes. Well, no, I'm going to be late round. Well, I'm at Russell's house and Robert's just left him. I know, they're such drama queens. I love it. What's that? You are kidding me! Scott slept with Robert 3 weeks ago. Scott, what are you like? I'm so jealous of you gay guys. You all sleep with each other and there's no consequences. Well, listen, babes, I'm going to be out of here as quick as I can, so let's say the mixer in 20. I want all the juicy goss, capiche? Oh, and Scott, I bought the hat. To die for! OK, ciao for now, babes. Yeah, bye. Russell need a big kiss and a snuggle.
No.
Yes, come on, darling, let it all out. Hey, I bet you in 1 week's time you've slept with, like, 50 totally different men.
I think you'd better go.
Uh-uh, no way, Jose. Now, you babes, get yourself into that kitchen. Give me nicotine, give me caffeine, fetch a big fuck-off box of tissues. And me and you is gonna sit ourselves down and have a girl-to-girl talkie, capiche?
I am not a girl! I'm a man! And at least I've had a boyfriend, which is more than be said for you, you stupid fucking shit!
I just love gay guys.
Right, if you just come this way. The entrance to this particular cave is quite low down, so mind you don't bump your heads. Now, not a lot of people know that Stump Hole Cavern takes its name from the crippled prostitute. We used to ply a trade here in the 17th century. If you look carefully up there, you can still see her talith etched into the limestone in soot. Shoot thy muck upon my bristles and visage. A penny. Up the shitter. A guinea, like dogs, gratis. Stick close behind me, mind the shale on these steps, it's quite slippy. We are, of course, part of a much wider network of caverns that riddle the entire county, including the much larger Red Scar caverns located some half a mile away to the west. A trifle flashy, for my taste, I have to say, with their gift shop, granary-style cafeteria and 100% safety record plastered all over their promotion. Well, there you go. Now, if we stay in single file, we'll make our way into the main cavern. I do think it's worth pointing out that Red Scar were served with a council notice ordering them to replace 115 yards of faulty wiring. Put it this way, I wouldn't like to get caught down there in a thunderstorm and no amount of trilobites in perspex or stegosaurus-shaped pencil tops is going to change that. This particular cavern may already be familiar to you from its countless appearances on the small screen. In 1974, you couldn't move down here for Cybermen. In fact, there was a rather amusing incident in which Tom Baker sprained his ankle on that rock there. Just goes to show how easily accidents happen. Yes, we've had all the celebrities down here, including the late Don Henderson of Bullman fame. The Chuckle Brothers. in an episode set in Barry's secret lemonade factory. And Michael Burke and the 9990. It's around about this stage of the tour I like to raise the subject of darkness. You know, there's nothing quite like the darkness we get down here in the caves. And to illustrate this, we do like to turn out all the lights just for a few moments. I myself, not fond of the darkness. I sleep with the lights on now. It's in the darkness I see the boy's face. Eyes protruding. Tongue out. Black. If you look over here, you'll see some of the limestone formations for which Stumpole is more famous. Used to be more famous. And over the years, the lads have given them a variety of comical names depending on what they're meant to look like. So here we have Santa Claus, his beard and sack. The Wombles. You see how the sediment forms the brim of Orinoco's hat. The specimen jar, the toffee apple, and Errol Flynn. This one over here, people say to me, Mick, that doesn't look like anything at all, but I don't know. When I look at it, I seem to see a little pair of hands clutching at a slippery wet rope, sliding down, down into the black water. Sometimes I'll stand here for hours, just looking at you. That concludes the main part of the tour, if you'd follow me. Michael Burke did say to me, Mick, you can't go on blaming yourself, it wasn't your fault. But I don't know, young kiddie like that, whole life ahead of him. School trip tragedy, local man blamed. Every day the same, parade of blank faces. The constant drip, drip from the cavern roof. The cold indifference of the ancient rock. But you keep going, don't you? It's like the moss growing around that little light bulb there. Life finds a way. Look at that skein of iron oxide. You wouldn't find anything like that in Red Scar. Remember the guide on your way out. Hello, Mrs. Hall.
Hello, Tony, Julie. Your boyfriend's here. Come through, Tony. This is Julie's dad.
So they tell me.
All right, Tony.
All right.
Sit down, Tony. She won't be long now. Hey.
Julie! She'll not be long now, Tony. She's like her mama, trying on every dress she's got.
That wouldn't take me long. I've only got two dresses. Charlie won't buy me clothes.
She's lying, Tony. I do buy her clothes. She just can't fit into them anymore.
He can talk, can't he?
You going for them cigs or what?
Yeah, in a minute. What are you up till tonight, Tony?
Oh, we're just going for a meal and that.
Oh.
Hey, you want to go down Swiss? They do good meals now.
They're not going down Swiss. That's where it took us on our honeymoon. It's a right dump.
No, it's not, Tony. They've done it up since then. It's like a big ship now with shells and nets and that.
Yeah, and it stinks of fish. We go down that Luigi's, you know him?
Oh. His name's not Luigi, remember?
Do you want a beer, Tony? You can have one.
You don't have to have one if you don't want one.
Oh, let the lad have a beer.
He don't want a beer. You don't have to get drunk to have a good time, do you, Tony?
You would if you were married to that, eh, Tony?
Ah, she's lovely.
Oh, you're joking, are you?
Charlie, if you want a beer, just get one. Don't make the lad have one, you fat pig.
Shut up, you bastard.
Let's go and check
you out. You fucking sit down. Don't let him frighten you.
Stella!
What?
So are you working then, Tony?
I'm at college, actually.
Oh, I bet you're dead brainy. What are you learning?
Modern languages. Oh.
Do you follow football, Tony?
Speak a language.
Who's your team?
No, I don't really follow football.
Do you do Spanish?
Un poquito.
Un poquito? Do you like them Gypsy Kings?
Does he, do you, Tony?
Is that all right?
Oh, that's it. I'm coming to live with you. You can be my tie by.
Take her, Tony. You're bloody welcome to her.
If you weren't going out without Julie, I could show you some things.
I've seen them, Tony. They'll make you sick.
Julie won't know what to do.
Big fat ass.
She's just a stupid little girl. She wears glasses, you know.
I know.
I could have gone to college, Tony.
Oh, don't listen to him. Tony is a liar.
She's bled me dry.
Oh, you're so boring. Such a boring man.
Well, look around you. She wants for now.
We haven't had sex in months.
I can't help that, Tony. I get tired.
You know I can't see colours.
Make something happen, Tony.
Please, Tony.
Tony, please.
I'm going to get Julie. Excuse me.
Oh, don't end up like us, Tony. You're still young.
Charlie's only 42, look at him. It's a joke.
Where do the years go, Tony? I've lost whole years.
We've never done now. You learn Spanish!
Mind how you go, son.
Oh, Charlie. What are we going to do now?
Should we go down Swiss?
Oh, yeah. And I've heard tell she'll soon own half the county.
Well, if I've learned anything in my long years as magistrate of this district, Mr. Fitzherbert, it is never to underestimate Mrs. Sarah Sheridan. True, true.
I say, who's that fellow yonder?
Ah, there you have hit upon a mystery, Mr. Peel. That is none other than Sir Quincy Steyer.
Steyer?
Aye, the most infamous blackguard in all of London. I've heard tell he'll soon own half the county.
What, the other half?
Yes.
Sink me, Fitzherbert. I don't like the cut of him. Not one jot. Let's see if we can't rouse him from his contemplation.
Yeah, take care, Peel.
Take care.
Take care.
Aye.
It is not for nothing that Sir Quincy has a reputation. There are those that claim he is in league with the very devil himself.
Well, devil or nay, we shall see. To His Majesty King James, may he live long in exile. Will you not join me in the loyal toast, sir? I am addressing you, sir.
Yeah, have a care, Peel.
My loyalties lie elsewhere, Mr. Peel.
You know me, sir.
Better than you think.
My friend meant no harm, Sir Quincy.
Thank you, Fitzherbert. I am a rationalist. I'm not enthralled to this gentleman's dark reputation.
Rationalist, eh? A man of science. A gentleman should think more carefully before bandying around such voguish terms.
Tis no vogue, sir. Think of Newton and Harvey. The circulation of the blood is an observed fact, not the stuff of shadow and whimsy peddled by your kind.
And where, pray, would your Mr. Newton stand? On the subject of the immortal soul.
Oh, these are dark waters, Frederick.
Newton would tell you, as I do, sir, that such childishness is best confined to the nursery.
I see. I wonder, are you a betting man, Mr. Peel?
I have been known to venture the occasional wager.
Frederick, no!
Very well. Since you scoff at the notion of an immortal soul,
You will not object to placing your own in hazard. Set against this trifle, I will wager my entire Cornish estate and £100.
£100?
Aye.
All that for my soul. Why, 'tis no wager. It's like snatching a poppet from a babe. I'll do it.
Excellent.
What shall we play?
What know you of Eight Men Down?
Nothing.
What of Bamalama Fizzvaj? Well, surely, sir, even you must know Go Johnny Go 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 Go!
You do. Jacks are worth 10, kings are worth 3.
Apart from one-eyed jacks, which are wild cards.
But we'll come to those in a moment.
Round one, you get a hand of 9, round two, a hand of 7.
Who's a wild card?
But we'll come to those in a moment. Will you deal the cards, young man?
I will, sir. Good evening. We are Legs Akimbo Theatre Company.
Thanks a lot. Oh.
Some of you may remember us from a couple of Christmases ago. We came here and we did Bins and Needles. It was a play about tramps on heroin. But we're back here today to perform my new piece, which is about a small girl growing up in the north. It's called Scumbelina. And we'll be performing that for you right here on the stage in a few minutes.
My name's Oliver Plimsolls, by the way, and I'll get all your names in a minute, because there are far too many of you.
A lot of my friends did turn to me and say, Ollie, what are you doing writing a play about the North? You're from Chiswick. I said to her, Sue, for years writers have sat on their fat asses getting rich writing lies about real Northern people. I want to do that too. Very exciting time for the company. First time I've written a play for adults. I'm not standing up here today as teacher. You know, I'm not sir. I'm not mum. I'm not dad. I'm Ollie Plimsolls, and I'm not going to patronise you. Patronise means to talk down to you. So, yeah, there's a little girl with a round face there. If you've got something to say, miss, pop your hand in the air. We'd all love to hear it. There's obviously something frightfully funny going on down there. Do you want to share it with the rest of the group? I'd love to know what the joke is. I'd love to be as funny as you. I'd love to be as popular as you. Oh, please, let me learn from you! Oh, it's not nice being bullied, is it? Maybe don't! Oh, nearly there, okay. Sit back, enjoy Scumbelina, which I wrote. Shh.
Coming around.
Coming to see me.
Nice tits.
Sold!
Out at Boozer.
Out on Raz.
Down at Nightclub.
Bry.
Side.
And Gaz.
Here.
She.
Tie.
Here.
She.
Tie.
Here.
She.
Tie.
Here. She.
Tie.
Here. She.
Tie.
Here. She.
Tie.
Here. She. Tie.
Here sheep tie,
here sheep tie.
Why? Why?
Parky out.
Parky in.
Parky out.
Parky in.
Parky in.
Parky out.
Where are you going?
Mind your own stink.
Oh, mind your stink.
Mind your stink. Stink, stink, stinking skint, skint. As I am.
Oh, poverty. Poor.
Poverosity.
That's right, Ma. No bastard listens to voice to little person. Not here in dump. But why don't you? Can't or won't? There's poetry in our voices, only it doesn't come out right. Poverty is poetry with an extra... Only that rhymes with it. Ah, but you're all welcome. Quick, get the fire lit, Ma. Father's home.
I should fetch coal, ain't love.
Fuck a duck!
I know. The duck's fucked. The duck's fucked off.
Fucked off, mucked off, more like. Mucked off with my luck. England's a duck. England's an old duck in a lake. She wants to fly, but she never can do. She wants to fly, she never will do. There's always a clipping her wings.
She sings.
I preferred them days. Not these days, sleaze days, them days, them lazy, hazy, daisy days. Not these cold, all, no soul.
Can I do a speech? Can I?
I will then.
Taps. Big taps on me bath, rusting away.
Like the country.
Country? Country, more like. rusting away like the taps on Mars' big bath. Big, brown, bleach-burning bath. I want the taps to work. I want me man to work. I want work for me man, but there ain't none. Not hearing. Nurse! Not hearing, nurse!
Not hearing, Nio, you are here!
Kendall!
You know me.
Until that first hello, until that first smile. But if I had to do it all again, I wouldn't change a thing. 'Cause this love is everlasting. Suddenly.
Of steam, iron and steel, magnolias only as old as your fee, licks the cat weasel, pop goes the top of the range, Grinch Hill, why won't you speak to me, Roland of hope and glory, hallelujah, chorus and them, us and them, us and them.
Them who made us this way.
Who made us this way, who?
Jim Cartwright.
Willie Russell.
John fucking Godber.
Cartwright. Russell. Fucking Godber. Cartwright. Russell. Fucking Godber. Cartwright. Russell. Fucking Godber. A Cartwright. A Russell. A fucking a Godber. A Cartwright. A Russell, a fucking a gummer, a Cartwright, a Russell, a fucking a gummer, a Cartwright, a Cartwright, a Cartwright.
They can't write.
We'll be right back.
we're not in Royston Vasey anymore.
Indeed.
Are we in heaven, Edward?
I don't think so, Tobbs. Remember I told you heaven was like Swansea?
Yes.
Well, this is the other place.
You mean?
Yes, London!
Is London a local place for local people?
No, Tubbs! London is a town of strangers, verminous youths who drink all day and rot all night.
Sounds nice. Can we stay for a weekend? I want to see Les Mis.
Silence! If we are to enter the kingdom of Swansea, we must leave this place at once.
But there are so many of them, Edward. 1, 2, 3, 5, 12, 6, 10. Lines and lines and lines and lines and lines and lines and lines. We'll never kill them all.
We mustn't kill them. Not yet. Anyway. First, we must redeem ourselves.
Edward, I told you to go before we left the shop.
To find redemption, we must return to Royston Vasey and atone for our sins.
But how will we get there?
Click your moon boots together 3 times. And repeat after me. I can, I can't.
I can, I can't. I can, I can't. I can, I can't.
That's it, Tom.
I can, I can't.
Keep going. We'll be home soon.
Ladies and gentlemen, the management regret to announce that the great Chauvel, the world's foremost animal magician, is unable to be here tonight as advertised. However, a last-minute replacement has been found.
Hello. Well, first I'd like to thank the management for giving me this opportunity to demonstrate my prestidigitation. This is not my day job, you understand, although it's always gone down very well with my clients. In fact, I've lost count of the number of them who've said to me, Mr. Chinnery, I wish you were a magician. and not a vet. So, please, join me now as we enter a world of mystery.
Oh dear, oh dear. Is there a vet in the house?
Just a Coke, please, Jeff.
Hey!
Another lager.
Right. Hey! Three bluebirds! Do he's bloody deaf, him.
Well, you know what they say, Jeff.
What?
Well, you know.
Hey? I can't hear you!
I said, bummers are deaf.
Yeah, it's a good one, that.
Isn't it? I fell for it at all.
Yeah. Hey, Bri, tell Mike Mau Mau.
You what?
You know, that one about the Mau Mau.
Oh, I can't remember that, Jeff. You tell
it. No, you can't, Mike. Danny Torres told us this joke at the Con Club, didn't he? It is the funniest bloody joke. Tell it, Bri.
Me?
Yeah, go on.
All right.
It's really good.
There's these three fellas.
Yeah, Englishman, Irishman, Scotchman.
Yeah, Englishman, Irishman, Scotchman. They get lost in the desert.
No, jungle.
Is it?
Yeah, go on.
All right, they get lost in the jungle and get killed by these cannibals.
No, no, yeah, you missed the old bloody joke, aren't you, idiot?
Well, I can't remember it, Jeff. You tell it.
No, you can.
It's all right, I'm not bothered, actually.
No, sit down!
Hey?
Sit down! Telling a joke. Now just think what the end is and go back.
Right. There's an Englishman.
Fruit.
What?
It's the fruit!
Oh!
He remembers
yes,
it now!
Right, right, Englishman, right, right. They've got to go out into the jungle and pick 10 pieces of fruit and bring them back. So they come back and the chief says, so Englishman.
Oh. Do the voice!
The chief says, so Englishman, now you must choose between death or Mau Mau. The Englishman says, we English will not bow to you, savages. I'll choose Mau Mau. So they grab him and they stick the 10 pieces of fruit up his ass.
Yeah, and what did he pick?
Oh, the Englishman chose cherries.
Cherries, imagine that, mate! 10 cherries stuffed up your ass! Cherries aren't really small though, are they? Come on, Brian.
Right. So the chief says the Scotchman and says death...
Death or Mau Mau.
Scotchman says Mau Mau and... Ooh. What's the Scotchman's fruit, Jeff? Is it bananas?
No, no, no. Smaller than that. Oh, just a sec.
Well, let's just say banana.
No, it's too big. It spoils the next one.
Apple.
No!
Strawberries?
Oh, what, in the jungle? No, just think what this is for a minute.
Hey, Brian, why are there no aspirins in the jungle?
Dunno.
Because the parrots eat them all. Yeah?
See, I'd have said paracetamol.
Well, either way, I think it works, you know?
You see any of Pam and Barry Swift, you know?
Oh, God, no, not in ages. Not
plums!
What?
It's plums, come on!
Oh, Jeff, it doesn't matter now!
What's it fucking matters? It's right near the end! There's only the Irishman left. Come on, Brian. Chief turns to the Irishman, he says, death or Mau Mau.
You didn't do the voice.
Doesn't matter! Finish it!
Can't remember.
Finish it!
I can't remember.
Please!
Jeff!
I honestly can't remember.
Oh, it's just a big fucking joke to you, idiot! Oh, yeah, Jeff can't tell a joke. Jeff is a joke! Jeff enters a talent competition and loses! My mum said I would win.
I was only 8. We'll have got this gun, do you? You! We're gonna tell this joke! And we're all gonna laugh! Rosie gets it!
Right. I'll finish the joke. Yeah. Jesus Christ. The chief turns to the Irishman and says, "Death,
don't go, Mau Mau."
And the Irishman looks at his fruit.
Pineapples!
He looks at his pineapples and he says, "I don't think I can stand the Mau Mau. I'll choose death." And the chief says to him,
"Get it right, Brian."
The chief says to the Irishman, "Oh God, I can't remember."
He says, "Death by Mau Mau."
Yeah, have you heard it?
Yeah.
It's got no intent. All
right, three movers.
Good night, Kinder! What a warm entry! Guten Abend, Kinder, und willkommen in England. Hi, welcome to England. My name is Tearlip, and I may enjoy you to this exchange visit to the capital city of London. Oh, danke schön. Now, as you may know, you will all be sleeping with some families in London. And wherever possible, I've tried to make boys sleep with boys and the other ones sleep with the other ones. This just tastes better in my eyes. I myself will be renting for most of the week. I found a very nice little cottage where I can get my head down without being disturbed. It's quite good. If any of you know of any better erections in London, then don't hesitate to let me know. I'm not fussy where I put myself. Alice Clark! Good, Alice Clark. Now, to make love with you this evening, I thought we could learn some traditional English games, which is going to be a real good treat. There are many exciting English games, for example, Hopcock, British Bull Dykes, and Stick Your Tail in a Donkey. Two name but a three. But tonight, Kinder, heute Abend, we are going to learn the rules to Blind Man's Puff. And of course, for this, I need to find a boy to play with. So. I'm just going to creep amongst you, see if I can finger a boy. Don't look so nervous, I don't bite. I may suck, but I don't bite. Now, what's this, a boy or a girl? Sorry, the moustache threw me. Now! Woo! What is your name?
Nick.
Nick, big round of applause for Nick, please! Nick! Woo! Nick! Okay. Now, don't be nervous, Nick.
I made a boy come on stage last night. Please, I can assure you, by the end, you'll be lapping it up. Now... What's in there that's so interesting? Okay, please. Okay, Nick. Now then, we need to decide for the game to begin whether Nick is to be the poof or the blind man. So what do you think, boys and girls? Do they know something I don't know? Okay, no. I think perhaps because Nick is a virgin that I should be the poof. Okay, Nick. Turn your back to me, please. Don't flatter yourself, Nick. Okay, I'm just going to tie you up now. Stop wriggling. Okay, now, as I do this, I will explain the rules to you, but I warn you now, I do have a tendency to gobble. It's all right, you can pull out at any time, but... you'll enjoy it so much more if you hold still. Okay, now listen, Nick. The game begins when you creep around the room and try to catch somebody. When you have them, you must entertain whether they are a male member or a femidom. So I'm going to give you a little clue if you'd like to hold out your hand. Lower, please. I'm older than you. I'm just having difficulty getting it up. Okay. Come on, boys and girls, I'm sure you've seen one of these before. I know it's a big one and it smells funny. But I can assure you, Nick, it tastes very nice. Okay, now see if you can tell me who this is, Give it a good squeeze. Any ideas? If it helps you, I can peel back the skin at the end. Any ideas, Nick? Who do you think that is? The Queen of Duisburg, otherwise known as? Helen is the right answer. Big round of applause for Nick, please. Thank you, Nick. Nick, now. You can either take your seat back in the audience or come backstage for some Duisburg coffee. It's totally up to you, which... it's your loss. Nick, boys and girls, thank you to Nick! It's Nick! You know, sometimes I get a boy up on stage and I find it impossible to pull him off. Although I usually manage it.
Well, that's all from me. Enjoy the rest of your evening. Sleep tight. And remember, don't let the bugger bite you. Cheers!
Levinson, I was just polishing your knockers. Bills, 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 Visa, Amex, diners, club, gold. Don't you just dread the footfall of the postman? Is that the one where Jack Nicholson does it on the kitchen table? Sort through these, would you, Iris?
Yes, Mrs. Levinson.
What's this, £950? Oh, of course, Eddie and I went to Covent Garden last month. Do you like opera, Iris?
Can't stick her. We prefer Kilroy.
I've got them all on CD, of course. Wagner, Strauss, three tenors.
For two CDs, daylight robbery.
My favourite is Der Rosenkavalier.
Oh, now Ron loves that one.
What?
But we traded ours in for an escort, so...
Isn't culture a wonderful thing, Iris? The more we learn, the more we are enriched, and you can glean so much from the telly box these days, if you have a dish. Do you get UK gold?
No, we like stock.
When Eddie and I first married, he turned to me...
Time's up.
That was never an hour.
That's what you always say, lady.
Good. Very well. But be careful with it. It's very expensive.
I know. Sort through those, would you, Judy?
Yes, Mrs. Krell.
Oh. Bills, bills, bills. Don't you just dread the footfall of the postman?
Oh, these are nice panties, Mrs. Krell.
Oh, do you think so? Ronnie gets me them in Paris.
Of course, I won't get expensive briefs.
Oh, you should treat yourself from time to time.
No, it's just I get through that many pairs, Eddie pulling at them with his big fingers.
Yes, well, I must get ready for the bridge evening.
I'm giving up wearing anything in bed. There's no point with Eddie's libido the way it is. He's like a lad of 19 sometimes.
Expecting quite a houseful, actually.
5-6 times a night and the mornings.
Yes, well, when Ronnie and I were first married...
Well, it's always been like that for us. It just gets better and better. He has me doing stuff that would make a whore blush.
Sometimes you wear nothing but a kimono around the house.
This way, that way. Some of it barely legal. I'm lying there thinking, will this pleasure never end?
Yes, but then...
She's back!
Oh, Christ. She's going to catch us one day.
Quick!
Evening, Mrs. Levinson.
God, I'm sick of this. We're going to have to tell her, you know.
What, that we pretend this is our house?
No.
Not that my husband is really dead.
No.
Not that we're really mother and daughter.
No. That we're both men.
Oh, Dad!
Come here, son.
Okie dokie, pig in a pokey! Good evening, job seekers! My God, I've never seen so much dole scum under one roof before. Has no one got a job in this frigging place? Nah, no, you're all too busy flicking yourselves off to Anne Robinson, eh? I thought so. Right, before we begin, has everyone got a pen? No, I don't give pens to people like you. It's not safe. A quick word about Pauline's pens. They're like gold dust...
The victim's name was Pauline Campbell-Jones. Occupation, restart officer. The victim had no family and in her will left everything to her pens. After the initial investigation, a prime suspect emerged. Please state your name.
Ross Gaines.
Can you describe to us your relationship with Miss Campbell-Jones?
Yes, I hated her.
Can you think of anyone who would have wanted to kill her?
I can't think of anyone that wouldn't. She was an evil woman. I remember one time we were doing a role-play exercise about interview technique. She'd asked me to interview her for an imaginary job.
And you can make it as hard as you like, Ross. I won't get cross. In your own time.
So, you're interested in this trolley job?
That is right. I am very interested, yes. I feel that my ability to work well as part of a team and yet take individual responsibilities are important factors in a job of this nature.
What work experience have you had?
I left school early and started to work...
Oh, so you didn't go to college?
No, I felt that actual work experience...
So you have no qualifications?
Well, if you don't count 20 years in the employment service...
Well, no, I don't. I'm talking about academic achievements, degrees, diplomas...
Oh, come off it, Ross! Shoving trolleys round Asda car park, a fucking monkey could do it!
Would you say you're a fairly egregious person?
What?
Are you an egregious person? Do you have an egregious personality?
Yeah, I do, yeah.
Right. I'm going to say some other words to you now, and I want you to reply with the first thing that comes into your head, all right?
Right, yes.
Home.
Royston Vasey.
Family.
Dead.
Friends.
Pens.
Friends.
Pens! They're the best friends you can have. Everything I know about people I learned from pens. If they don't work, you shake them. If they still don't work, you chuck them away. Bin them!
Really, work?
Everything. My work is everything to me.
Love?
No.
Oh, so you never married?
No. There was somebody once...
Can I get your age, please, Pauline?
I think that's a lady's prerogative.
I need to know how old you are for these records.
Well, let's just say I'm as old as me gums and a little bit older than me.
How old are you?
48!
Right, thank you for coming to see us today.
Thank you very much. When do I start?
Oh, I'm sorry. I can't offer you this position.
You what?
Well, you failed the interview. You strike me as a bully. You're ill-mannered. Ignorant. Foul-mouthed. You're not qualified for this job. And apart from anything else, you're too old. Miss. Sorry.
Good, thanks very much for that, Ross. Do you want to take your place?
Yep.
Yes, I feel Ross handled that situation very well, job seekers. Although it did make me wonder how well he'd handle a situation that was a bit more like this. Oh! Ooh, a bully am I? Foul fucking man! Well, you late now, well, it's egregious, egregious! Is this what it means? Is it egregious enough for you?
Stop it, bully! You nutter!
Ames' story led us to our second suspect, someone who had known Pauline for longer than anyone, having been on the dole since the age of 12. Please state your name.
My name is Mickey.
Did you know the deceased well?
Is that a pub?
How well did you know Miss Campbell-Jones?
She was kind to me. She bought me a tuna sandwich.
Did she ever do anything else that you thought was kind?
Not really. Sometimes she made me feel stupid.
Polly. You're not yet, Mickey love, I'm busy. Right, job seekers, who can tell me what CV stands for? No, Mr. Waddy love, it's not Church of England.
Polly.
What is it, Mickey?
I've got an interview.
You, an interview? Don't make me laugh. What's it for,
scarecrow? No. Fireman.
Woo! Fireman, eh? Are you going to show us your hose pipe? That was a joke, Mickey loves. Smells bad enough in here as it is. Excuse me. Where do you think you're going?
Interview.
Well, I'm sorry, Mickey love, but I can't let you go.
Why?
Because we do not cover interview technique till next Monday fortnight. As well you know, you've done this course 62 times already.
63.
Besides, what's going to happen to me if you all get jobs before the end of this course?
Sat in the door.
Exactly. I'll be sat down here with this lot stinking of shit.
Please let me go, Pauline. I feel confident.
Well, you look ridiculous. Show me your helmet. The one on your head! Oh, watch this now, Dick fucking Whittington! You'll be wanting to see men dressed up as women next. That, Mickey Love, is what chance you have got of becoming a fireman. A big fat zero. Now sit down, play with your crayons, and we'll hear no more about it. Right, the rest of you. To lighten the mood a little bit, we're going to play a game I've invented called Shopper Scrounger.
Our third and final suspect arrived in the shape of a fat woman. State your name, please, madam.
Reece!
Occupation?
Restart, officer. I was assigned to take over from Pauline, the victim.
And how did she react to this news?
I think she took it quite well.
Piss off, you big fat cunt.
Accept it, you are finished!
Fuck you, Ann Widdicombe! And leave my pens alone, please!
Pens, you make me laugh!
Don't knock pens!
You are a relic woman! Out to the fucking museum and clean the bastard bins on your way out. This is the future, computer discs.
Don't you wave your floppies in my face, lady, or I will I'll shove them where the sun don't shine.
You knew where you're heading, don't you?
No.
Prison.
Oh, do I look like Deirdre Rashid?
Yes! I've seen this before. It's this job. It gets to women like you.
I don't have to listen to any more of this shit.
I know you don't. Piss off.
I think I fucking will. And just what do you mean exactly? Women like me?
You know what I mean.
I told you it was Dick fucking Whittington, didn't I?
You're hard as nails on the outside, but inside you're just a pussycat.
It was horrible. Like two big fat white balloons banging about. That was just Pauline.
How did this make you feel, Mickey? Angry? Dejected?
Sick, mainly. I thought that she loved me, but she did not.
Where did you get the gun?
I borrowed it from my Uncle Jeff. Told him it was for hunting squirrels, so he said, all right.
Mickey, have you heard of a crème passionnelle?
Is it a cake?
No, it is a crime of passion. Oh. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I put it to you that this poor bastard is no more capable of murder than you or I, especially with malice aforethought.
Oh, shit.
His only crime was to have loved too much, a crime of which the victim was all too innocent. The defendant may be simple, backward, retarded even.
Yeah!
But his very pores weep with innocence and pus. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, do you find the defendant guilty or not guilty?
Royston Vasey 4444244. Oh, hello, Deborah. Has there been any news? Well, what did the lawyer say? Well, that's a cake, isn't it? Have they reached a verdict yet? Oh, Deborah, that's fantastic. Oh, I'm so pleased. Well, he'll be home in time to watch The Weakest Link now. Yes, I'd flick myself off to that, too. Well, listen, Deborah, you give him a big hug from me and tell him I always knew they'd find him innocent. Just a second, Deborah, that's the door. Now, don't hang up, I won't be a moment. Yes?
Hello, Dad!
Sorry?
Is that Dave?
I think you got the wrong house.
Okay, Dave, is Dave there?
No, there's no one called Dave here.
Okay, Dave. Dave, my wife would like to use your toilet.
No, I really don't think that I...
Don't worry, Dave, she won't go in your sink again.
Hello, Dave. Wanna buy some pegs, Dave?
I'm sorry?
I got some pegs belonging to you.
No, I'm all right for pegs, thank you. Is your wife...
My wife?
Yes, is she...
Don't worry about her, Dave. She won't belong. Get sat down if you like.
Look, there's been a misunderstanding. You're in the wrong house.
Ah, poor Peter Purvis, the blue Peter dog, Petra's dead.
Dave, my wife tells me there is a block in your toilet.
No, there isn't.
There is now. Get sat down, Dave. My wife will begin the reading.
Look, I've nothing against you travelling people, but you're intruding on my property. I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
You thought of already. Nobody need me, Baba.
You're not dead.
Yes, I know. This is what I've been trying to tell you.
It's okay, Dave. My wife will continue to read your fortune, but you must cross her palm with silvers.
I haven't got any silver. Oh, that's my wedding ring.
This is just a saga now. I'm going to toilet, Dave. But I'll be back in a moment.
Please help me. He thinks I'm his wife.
What?
He made me go with him. Please help me.
Who is he?
I don't know. He just came to my house.
But you speak to him that language.
I make it up. It's gibberish. Look, he's coming back. Please do as he says. He's a very dangerous man. He'll stick pipes in you.
My wife was right. There is a block in your toilet. But I fixed it now.
Thank you.
That's okay. Oh, Dave!
Yes?
In the case of why I'm warm, for instance, with enough brush pans. I see it now as a pineapple.
Kumbaya. Tixilix. Sandu. Benosarasmi.
Of course you can. We would love you to join us.
Gentlemen, welcome to It's Bernice. Do you know there's a lot of suffering in the world, and as an agony aunt, I often get asked to try and help ease it. I like to think of myself as the betnovate rubbed on the eczema of people's day-to-day suffering. Now, if you're anything like me, you can often be found standing in the street laughing at the severely disabled. But I want you to rein those instincts in tonight as we meet my special guest, Pam Austwick, who suffers from a terrible condition. It must make her life a living hell. I'm talking, of course, about tonight's disease in focus. So please, welcome upon the stage, Morbid Obesity.
Susan.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Down you.
Get your breath back, love. Get it back and tell us, have you always been such a big woman?
Well, no, Beneath, this is the funny thing, you see. I got two sisters, thin as you like. You put them next to me at Christmas, it's like two matchmakers and a cream egg.
So it's not a hereditary disorder, then?
No, no, no. The doctors say it's glandular.
As if. I mean, it's mumbo-jumbo a lot of the time, isn't it? What do you think is the matter with you?
I think I can trace it back to when Mum died.
Fam, you poor thing.
We was very close, you see, and when Mum went, it created this big gap in me life. I think I'll try to fill that gap. By eating.
I understand. You're a very brave lady, Pam, I must say it. You've shown a lot of guts just coming on.
Thank you, Winnie, thank you.
You're welcome. It's an emotive subject. It poses a lot of questions. I'm sure that there is a particular question that's going through the audience's mind as we speak. I know it's going through my mind. And that is, how on earth do you wipe your bum?
Sorry?
Well, I imagine you have trouble getting one cheek on the seat, never mind both at the same time. But you do get your knickers on prescription. Carry on.
Well, one of the key aspects of morbid obesity...
Or gluttony.
Well, we don't like to call it that.
Yeah, well, greed then.
Well, no, because how much I eat is no longer connected to how big I am.
Come off it, woman, the size of you. You're not telling me you live on skim milk and Ryvita.
I'm on a strictly controlled diet.
You're consisting of what? Lard sandwiches and deep-fried chocolate cakes.
Obesity is primarily an emotional condition.
No, it's not. It's primarily an overeating condition. Stuffing your face every hour, God sends. Eating margarine out of the tub with a big wooden spoon. Morbid over. I lost my mother. Didn't make me waddle through life with a tin opener in one hand, ice cream scoop in the other. Omelette, 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 omelette. Morbid obesity. Can we get a special name? You fat woman, fat! You want to lose weight? Stop eating! Anyway, I put it all in a fact sheet. Join me next week with obsessive compulsive disorders. Lord knows where they find them.
Good evening, rock fan. Now, Pickwick Records is proud to present, fresh from signing a $1 million contract and at the start of what we know will be a glittering solo career, singing the single Tarmakawakatani Pumpkin Face from the album Moods. Tonight, making his solo debut, formerly of Creme Brulee, Miss Les McQueen!
The shop looks so beautiful in the moonlight. Ooh!
What is it, Tubbs?
I just had the strangest feeling. Like someone walking over my grave.
Look!
What?
There's a light on in the shop.
There's someone inside.
Come on, Tubbs. We'll soon put a stop to this.
Careful, Edward. It may be a trap.
That's true. You go first.
Yes?
Oh, I'm sorry. Are you open?
Yes! Can I help you at all?
Well, I hope so. I'm doing some research for a book I'm writing. It's a history.
Local history?
Yes, and I wondered if you had any memories.
Well, yes, I've got two. They're not for sale.
No. You misunderstand me, dear lady. I'm trying to find out about this shop. What can you tell me about it?
But this is a local shop.
Yes. Well, do elaborate.
Blub, blub, blub.
Elaborate.
Blub, blub, blub.
Yes. I heard there was a fire.
Yes. The man and lady who lived here before were burned.
Arson?
Yes, him as well.
Apparently the police found traces of petrol. Do you know anything about that?
Oh, that'll be my husband, Edward. You see, he was bursting to redeem himself.
Hello, hello, what's going on? What's all this shouting? We all have no trouble here.
This man's writing a history.
Local history?
Yes, your wife was just about to share her memories with me.
Bitch, did he pinch them?
No, but he wanted to.
Breast pincher, eh? Mr. Titty Touch. Getting wood by finger nipping within? Come across your type before in the forces. You won't get far.
Edward and Tubbs Tat Syrup. They died in the fire along with their son, David. What can you tell me about them?
Why, they were good people. Loving local people. Their only crime was to resist change. They didn't like change.
We didn't even give change.
We?
Strangers would come to the town, to the shop. Young, most of them. In gangs of one or two. They wanted to browse, they wanted to finger the things.
My precious things.
They would offer us money in return for goods.
Well, you are a shop.
Yes, a local shop. Selling local goods to local people. We don't bother the outside world. We don't want it bothering us.
Edward!
The local shop stood on this site for generations. Reduced to ashes by the ignorance and fear of snooping breast pinchers like you. Prepare to die, stranger.
No, Edward!
Tubbs!
No more! Hasn't there been enough killing for one lifetime?
But he's not local!
It doesn't matter.
What?!
Don't you see, Edward? If you live in London, you're local to London. If you live in Plymouth, you're local to Plymouth. Everybody's local to somewhere.
Get out of my way, Tubbs, or so help me God, I will shoot you.
You said we had to redeem ourselves, Edward. This This is our chance. Let the man go, Edward. Let it all go.
Tubbs, I'm so tired.
You have chosen wisely. And now you have earned the right to enter the kingdom of swans. Who are you? Oh, I have many names. Some call me Jehovah, some Muhammad, some...
Mr. Titty Touch.
If you like. I knew that I had to test you to see that you were fully redeemed. And now you have atoned for your sins. You can spend eternity in my kingdom. Come, join us! Sorry, Edward. There's nothing for you here.